There will be no UIC tonight. However, there is Sunday Night Live, and a link will go out for that Zoom gathering where we will hear a presentation from Braver Angels. Please join us for that if you are able. We are still gathering food for distribution through Metro Public Schools, so if you have food that you would like to bring by and leave at the office, that would be greatly appreciated. There will also be a women's gathering on October the 22nd. So if you are a woman of St. David's and are interested in that, please mark your calendars. And finally, the bazaar is going to be a little bit different this year. One of our biggest sellers is food that parishioners have made. So if you are willing and able to contribute to that, please do so. And I'm sure you will be hearing more about exactly when that is needed as we move forward. So please now prepare your hearts and minds for worship as we come together to worship our God.
Thank you. A reading from the book of Exodus. When the people saw that Moses delayed to come down from the mountain, the people gathered around Aaron and said to him, "Come, make gods for us. Who shall go before us? As for this Moses, the man who brought us up out of Egypt, we do not know what has become of him." Aaron said to them, "Take off the gold rings that are on the ears of your wives, your sons, and your daughters, and bring them to me." So all the people took off the gold rings from their ears and brought them to Aaron. Aaron took the gold from them, formed it in a mold, and cast an image of a calf. And they said, "These are your God, O Israel, who brought you up out of the land of Egypt." When Aaron saw this, he built an altar before it. And Aaron made a proclamation and said, "Tomorrow shall be a festival to the Lord." They rose early the next day and offered burnt offerings and brought sacrifices of well-being. And the people sat down to eat and drink and rose up to revel. The Lord said to Moses, "Go down at once. Your people whom you brought up out of the land of Egypt have acted perversely. They have been quick to turn aside from the way that I commanded them. They have cast themselves with them an image of a calf and worshipped it and sacrificed to it and said, 'These are your gods, O Israel, who brought you up out of the land of Egypt.'" The Lord said to Moses, "I have seen the people, how stiff-necked they are. Now let me alone, so that my wrath may burn hot against them, and I may consume them. And of you I will make a great nation." But Moses employed the Lord, his God, and said, "O Lord, why does your wrath burn so hot against your people, who you have brought out of the land of Egypt with great power and a mighty hand? Why should the Egyptians say it was the evil intent that he brought them out to kill them in the mountains and to consume them from the face of the earth? Turn your fierce wrath, change your mind, and do not bring disaster upon your people. Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, your servants, how you swore to them by your own self, saying to them, 'I will multiply your descendants like the stars of heaven, and all this land that I have promised I will give to your descendants, and they shall inherit it forever.' And the Lord changed his mind about the disaster that he had planned to bring on his people." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let's read a portion of Psalm 106 appointed for today in unison. Hallelujah, give thanks to the Lord for what is good. His mercy endures forever. Who can hide the acts of God? Happy are those who act with justice and always do what is right. Remember me, O Lord, with the favor you have for your people, and visit me with your saving help, that I may see the prosperity of your elect and be glad with the gladness of your people, that I may glory in your inheritance. We have sinned as our forebears did. We have done wrong and dealt wickedly. Israel made a whole calf of earth and worshipped a golden image. And so they exchanged their glory for the image of an ox that feeds on grass. They forgot God, their Savior, who had done great things in Egypt, wonderful deeds in the land of Canaan, and fearful things at the Red Sea. So he would have destroyed them had not Moses, his chosen, stood for him to turn away his wrath from consuming him. A reading from Paul's letter to the Philippians. My brothers and sisters whom I love and long for, my joy and crown, stand firm in the Lord in this way, my beloved. I urge Eudoa and I urge Syntyche to be of the same mind in the Lord. Yes, and I ask you also, my loyal companion, help these women, for they have struggled beside you in the work of the gospel, together with Clement and the rest of my co-workers, whose names are in the book of life. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say, rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, Let your request be known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
I even attended the Martin Luther King Day service at 16th Street Baptist Church. I've not actively participated in Black Lives Matter protests, but I support the ideas of equal treatment, justice, and equality. As I know what I have and have not done personally, I feel like I have not fully lived into the role that you and I are called to as Christians. My age obviously made my participation in World War II and the Civil Rights Movement impossible. But have my efforts to learn more of our shared human history been enough? Should I be more of an active champion for causes now? As I read the lessons we have just heard in preparation to try to find some words of inspiration to share with you, I was struck by the passage from Philippians, and particularly by the phrase, "Be of the same mind as the Lord." When I consulted my commentary on this passage, and particularly this phrase, what I found was that the commentator had said, being of the same mind here means, quote, to adopt towards one another the humble mindset of Christ that is oriented toward the other's interest. Again, a humble mindset oriented toward the other's interest. The passage we heard today is near the end of Paul's rather brief letter to the folks at Philippi. But in this phrase, the people listening would have known that he had just said, only live your life in a manner worthy of the gospel of Christ, so that whether I come and see you or am absent and hear about you, I will know that you are standing firm in one spirit, striving side by side with one mind for the faith of the gospel, and in no way are intimidated by your opponents. Reading the passage from Philippians seems simple enough. Think like Christ. Or as a slogan popular a few years ago said, we should think, what would Jesus do? However, when I reflect on this directive, I am saddened by the state of our nation and our world today. From my perspective, there is more division amongst our friends and neighbors than I could ever personally recall. And these divisions are far more serious than UT versus Georgia or Coke versus Pepsi. I understand that these divisions are magnified by politics, especially in an election year. But the question remains, have any of us adopted the mindset of Christ? Paul, I believe, recognized that truly learning to think as Christ is a difficult task. And for someone to be successful requires the support from the entire community. Furthermore, I believe with every ounce of my being that part of having the mind of Christ means listening to everyone. Jesus himself demonstrated this when he welcomed those considered outcast and not worthy. I never intended this sermon to promote Sunday Night Live, but if you cannot escape the political frame of reference for this passage that seems so extremely obvious to me, you might wish to consider joining the conversation tonight on Zoom, where Braver Angels will provide a workshop called Bridging the Divide. And they will talk to us about what it takes to have constructive, non-polarizing conversations between people who disagree politically. My prayer for us all is that we can rejoice in the Lord, and that our hearts and minds will be filled and guarded by the peace we can only receive from God. So, brothers and sisters in Christ, I leave you with the words of St. Paul and encourage you to think about whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever.
come from heaven.
Was incarnate of the Holy Spirit as the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified in the Pontius Pilate.
He suffered death and was buried.
On the third day, he rose again,
in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead,
and his kingdom will have no end.
We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life,
who proceeds from the Father,
who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified,
who has spoken through the prophets.
We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church.
We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins.
We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
The prayers of the people form one, found on the Book of Common Prayer, page 383. With all our heart, all our mind, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy. For the peace of the world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all peoples, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Michael, our presiding bishop, for John, our diocesan bishop, and for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Donald, our president, for Bill, our governor, for John, our mayor, for the leaders of the nations, and for all in authority, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and community, and for those who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the good earth which God has given us, and for the wisdom and the will of the conservative, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel on land, on water, in the air, or through outer space, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the aged and infirm, for the widowed and the orphans, and for the sick and the suffering, let's pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those we name, either silently or aloud. For the special needs and concerns of Stuart Allen, Bill Hance, John Sacher, Judy Grace, Lucy Muse, John Kenneth, Marshall Wonderlick, Howard Green, the Arnold family, Nancy Creekwalk, Sharon McDaniel, McDonald, Britt Cox, Ron Fortenberry, all teachers and students, all persons suffering from the coronavirus, and those who care for them, all who are burdened with financial concerns or crisis, and for those we hold quietly in our hearts. We pray for those who are expecting children, especially Aaron and Emily Cox. We pray for peace and the healing of this country and around the world. We pray for all men and women in the armed forces at home and abroad and their families, especially Carla Kormar, Booksy Ferguson, Hunter Judd, Francis Meza, James Nelson, and Brian Wooden. For the poor and the oppressed, for the unemployed and the destitute, for the prisoners and captives and all who remember and care for them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have died in hope of the resurrection, especially Betsy Moran, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For deliverance from all danger, violence, oppression, and degradation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may end our lives in faith and hope, without suffering and without reproach, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
In the communion of David of Wales and all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord our God, confess that we have sinned against you, opposing your will in our lives. We have denied your goodness in each other, in ourselves, and in the world you have created. We repent of the evil that enslaves us, the evil we have done, and the evil done on our behalf. Forgive, restore, and strengthen us through our Savior Jesus Christ, that we abide in your love and serve only your will. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins in the grace of Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.